My name is Charles Turner, Jr. I joined the United States Army in October of 1964. I stayed in the Army from October 64 to October of 1967. I was trained as a medical records and reports specialist, but when you get to Vietnam, you do whatever is necessary, and that was help to build airstrips, flying on gunships, in an assault helicopter division, which medically evacuated fallen soldiers or soldiers who were hurt. I saw quite a few things that were very hurtful during that period of time.
It seems it's kind of painful, and this is one time that I did not see blood. But when I was leaving Vietnam and soldiers were getting off of those planes, and there were soldiers like me who were going back home to San Francisco, which I kissed the ground when I got to San Francisco International. But there was a young man from my neighborhood, and to this very day it haunts me that I can't think of his name or his family. But he was waving at me, he was just getting there. And it seems as if soon after then, I got a report from somewhere or another that he had been killed. Or close to that, in the Vietnam War, she was very supportive. And I remember seeing Martha Ray. She was a very, very famous comedian of that era. And Bob Hope came. And boy, there were so many soldiers, I was afraid that it could be such a major attack that would kill all of us. Well, I don't think it was a waste. I can't, because so many soldiers died, I could never, and were maimed and hurt. I could never, and even I suffer from post-traumatic stress disorder, I could never condemn the war or that. But I think that the United States underestimated the enemy that they were up against. I really think that we could have done without that war, but I can't condemn it because of all of the lives that were lost and the pain and suffering and the things that hurt me so bad during that period of time. I can't condemn them for it or wish that they wouldn't, because it's imperative that we have an army, and for quite a number of young men, it's a very good occupation. If there had not been a war going on, I think I would have stayed in the military myself. I love the military life. I really love the life, but I just did not want to go back to Vietnam or see the pain of that war again.